Good morning, this is Radesh. Chemistry is a branch of science which deals with the interaction of matter with its surroundings. It may be physical or chemical changes. So, chemistry is a branch of science which deals with the physical and chemical changes of the matter with its surroundings. Whether matter is directly participating in the chemical change or physical change, or if any other is participating, that is we are going to discuss. So, here matter can be divisible or not, that is a question. So, when we are going to ancient days, Greek philosopher Democritus coined one word known as atom. So, atom is a Greek word which means it is indivisible, and he says, in always in any chemical reaction, atom is going to participate and the matter can be divisible up to one smallest indivisible particle known as atom. But there is no experimental proof for the assumption made by Democritus. Based on these assumptions, John Dalton proposed his theory, Dalton's atomic theory. According to this theory, John Dalton says that chemical and physical changes includes atoms which are indivisible. So after that, but Michael Faraday proved that there is an interaction exists between matter and electricity. Because of these experiments, after so many days, discovery of electron, proton, neutron have been taking place by the scientists like J.J. Thomson, Goldstein and Chadwick respectively. It means atom is not indivisible, it is divisible, means it contains many other particles known as nucleons and fundamental particles like electron, proton, neutron. So these assumptions or these theories says that atom is not indivisible, it is divisible. After that, discovery of radioactivity, discovery of dual nature of electron, and after that, Thomson's atomic model proposed by J.J. Thomson, which is known as plum pudding model. After Thomson's atomic model, one more atomic model was proposed by Ernest Rutherford, known as Rutherford's planetary model. So, Rutherford's planetary model says that electrons are revolving around the nucleus, just like in a solar system, planets are revolving around the nucleus. But Rutherford's planetary model is failed to explain the stability of the atom. So that's why after that, Rutherford and his co-workers conducted alpha-ray scattering experiments. By these experiments, it was proved that atom contains nucleus. So nucleus has been discovered by Rutherford by doing alpha-ray scattering experiments by using radioactive material and by using gold thin foils. So by this we would like to explain about the discovery of subatomic particles. Means atom is divisible, it contains so many other particles. Out of these so many other particles, electrons and protons are known as fundamental particles, and remaining neutron and so many are known as subatomic particles. So till now we have discussed about Rutherford's atomic model, but now right now I would like to discuss about Bohr's atomic model. So Niels Bohr, to overcome the limitations proposed by Rutherford's atomic model and to explain this fine structure of hydrogen spectrum, proposed one more model known as quantum mechanical model, because this is based on classical laws of physics proposed by Niels Bohr. According to Niels Bohr, the first point is an atom contains nucleus in which the nucleons are present. So the nucleus occupies the center of the atom, and also the size of the nucleus is very very small when compared to the size of the atom. Suppose there is a cricket stadium, if it is considered as an atom, the small pea can be considered as the nucleus. So the size of the nucleus is very very small when compared to the size of the atom, and it occupies the center of the atom where nucleons are present inside it. And after that, about electrons. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus in outermost orbits. Just like in a solar system, the planets revolving around the sun. So, just like planets revolving around the sun, here the electrons are revolving around the nucleus, and the path of the electrons is circular. So, electrons are revolving around the nucleus in circular paths. At the same time, the force of attraction between this positively charged nucleus and electrons is to be balanced by the centrifugal force of moving electrons. After that one, out of infinite number of many orbits around the nucleus, only electrons can revolve only on those orbits which are having whose angular momentum is an integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Means here angular momentum of the electron is to be quantized by this Bohr's atomic model. That is the third point. So here quantized, that is angular momentum of the electron is quantized and can be represented by mvr is equal nh by 2 pi, where m is equal 1, 2, 3 and so on. mvr represents angular momentum, that is mass of the electron, velocity of the electron and r radius of the orbit. So mvr may be equal to 1h by 2 pi, 2h by 2 pi, 3h by 2 pi and so on, but it cannot have the fractional value of angular momentum. That is the third point. The fourth one is, when these electrons are remaining in those orbits, it is not able to radiate energy, means its energy remains constant on those orbits. That orbits are known as stationary orbits. Stationary orbits means the energy of the electron is to be remain constant while it remains in that place only. So these are known as stationary orbits or ground state orbits, because here the potential energy of the electron is minimum, so that the stability of the electron inside the stationary orbit is more. After that, we are going to discuss about energy levels. Means if you are moving far away from the nucleus, so many quantized energy levels are there which can be represented by K, L, M, N, O, like that. N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. We can represent by the numbers. Here, the energy of these energy levels increasing when we are going away from the nucleus. So these are the stationary states, and also these are associated with some energy. So these are known as energy levels, and these energy levels, energy is increasing when we are moving from away from the nucleus, which can be written by K, L, M, N, O, like that. And the next point is, when these electrons are, means the radiation of the energy takes place only in terms of radiation when the electron is emitting from inner to outer or outer to inner. Means when an electron is jumping from inner orbit to outer orbit, means by absorbing some energy, it is moving from lower to higher energy. At the same time, if it is moving from outer to lower, means by releasing some energy, means by radiation of energy, electrons are coming to inner orbits, known as emission. So absorption, emissions can be takes place only when electron jumps from either inner to outer or outer to inner. Otherwise, if it is constantly placing at the same orbit, same energy level, its energy will be constant. That is about emission and absorption.